The angel Moroni is typically set atop a spire on most LDS temples, but that's not the case with the Cartson, Alberta temple in Canada. It has neither an angel Moroni nor spires. Designed after Solomon's temple, it was the first LDS temple built outside the United States. Temple artist and author Chad Hawkins shares the history of the Cartson, Alberta temple.
In 1887, a group of 40 pioneers left Logan under the direction of Brigham Young to go settle southern Alberta, Canada. And those 40 pioneers, just 10 to 14 years later, developed into a thriving 3,000 plus Mormon colony in southern Alberta. And at that time, the over 3,000 active, faithful members in southern Alberta justified the need for a house of the Lord. One of the challenges in building the Cartson Temple is the fact that it's in the middle of nowhere. It's isolation. Enhances its majesty because it's in the middle of nowhere on a mound in the city of Cartson, but it's also very difficult to bring those materials in from great distances. And during the time of building the temple, those challenges were enhanced because of World War I. The local supplies were depleted because of the war, and they had to look at vast distances and bringing all of the granite and other building supplies in. When it came time to select a design for the temple, they chose a special architect. His name was Hiram Pope. Hiram Pope was a great architect in the West, in the Holy Western United States. He was the architect of the Laie Hawaii Temple, the Cartson Temple, the Mesa Arizona Temple, and then later he won the award to build the state capitol for Utah. Referring to the temple, he said that a temple of the Lord should not be a large Gothic cathedral, but rather the structure should be simple, yet majestic, to match the message of the restored gospel. When he designed the Cartson Temple, he designed it with a very simple flowing pattern. It was one of the very first temples to have the floor plan, the unique floor plan where you go through room, room, and another room until you finally enter into one of the higher rooms of the temple, which of course is the celestial room. I think that the Cartson, Alberta Temple is a great tribute to the church in Canada, specifically in Alberta, for how solid they were, how they were able to build the temple, use the temple. And today, their legacy lives on because today there are three temples in Alberta. Cartson was first within about 10 years ago, the Edmonton, Alberta Temple. And under construction today is a temple in Calgary. In all of my works of art, I always include hidden images. And in the Cartson Temple, I actually included two. When you walk into the Cartson Temple, into the entranceway, you will see a beautiful fountain. And behind the fountain is a frieze. It's a life-size, almost a life-size sculpture on the wall that depicts Christ visiting the Samaritan woman at the well. And so I thought, I want my hidden image to include that very depiction. And so in my watercolor painting, you will see the Savior speaking lovingly with the woman at the well. A second hidden image that I have in this temple is for the locals in Cartson. They have a famous landmark. It's actually in the United States, but you can see it from Cartson. And off in the distance, you'll look and you'll see a mountain structure that they refer to as Old Chief Mountain. And the profile is of a Native American wearing a headdress. Thus, it's called Old Chief. And in the shadows on the grass, you will softly see with the shadows Old Chief Mountain.
What great pictures. Thank you, Chad. For more information about Chad's books and his paintings, you can go to his website, chadhawkins.com. Coming up next, a 40th anniversary worth noting. The Ensign magazine marks a milestone.